You're listening to the Franchise Freedom Podcast with Giuseppe Grammatico.
Okay, and welcome to the Franchise Freedom Podcast. I'm your host, Giuseppe Grammatico, your franchise guide, and very excited to have you today. We have an exciting episode. And just a reminder, and actually wanted to thank everyone for joining us, but a reminder of, you know, we cover quite a bit on the show. We talk about helping corporate executives experience time and financial freedom via franchising, but we talk about all various vehicles from real estate to, we just had a guest talk to us about e-commerce and all the various vehicles of helping people figure out what they want to do in life, figure out what they want to do when they grow up. And we talk to a lot of first-time entrepreneurs looking to make that leap. So great show. Show is built on a lot of your questions, a lot of the comments we receive. So wanted to thank you for that. So let's dive in today. Our guest today is Jim Woods from the Woods Kovalova Group. Jim, welcome to the show.
Well, thank you very much, Giuseppe. I'm glad to be here.
I'm excited. I was on Jim's show, I think it was last week.
Yes.
And we shared our love for Rodney Dangerfield. So rest in peace. So
indeed.
had him in the background. I'm hard, you know, I got a hard connection today. So we'll let Rodney rest today. So give the audience a little bit of background of how you got into your current business and, you know, what your current business does, you know, who you serve and what you do.
Well, you know, we have a diversity, equity, and inclusion business, and it's not so much where we discuss cultures and races and all. That's a primary function of it, but it's where we talk about people finding the enthusiasm in their life to work with each other. And we show them ways that they can do that and to avoid some of the stumbling blocks that others have made and so they can grow their businesses. And you can't grow a business you can create a business, but you really can't grow a business successfully and meet the needs of your customers unless you understand where they're coming from. Mm. I started out several years ago, and frankly, I had been very, very successful at 3M company as one of the top salespeople in America. And then I decided that I wanted to start my own business. So I took a business plan to a guy that I had met at church, and I didn't want any money. I just wanted him to tell me if I was on the right track. Mm. And so I took the business plan, went over with him. He said, come back and call me in a couple of weeks or so. I called him one day and he said, come over and pick it up. And I just wanted some suggestions on the margins. That's
right.
All.
Right.
Excuse me. And I knew he did this for a number of people. I went by and the business plan was on his doorstep. His Mercedes, all of his cars were parked out front. And the business plan was right in his doorstep. I knocked on the door to get his opinion. No one ever answered. Never spoke to him again. I was so disappointed. I was depressed was not good enough. I went
home. No comments or anything? There were no comments?
No comments, no margins, no nothing. He was a member of my church, very highly successful person.
Huh.
So I got home. Everybody's at school. My wife has gone to work. And I'm staying in the kitchen and I'm crying. Oh boy, you know, I blew it. What am I going to do? Mm. Nobody wants me. Yo ho ho. So, I knew enough training to have my pity party and to get up. So I had my pity party standing in the kitchen, and then I got on the telephone and I have to do something. I cannot tell you why or how. I picked up the phone and I called information and got the number for Whirlpool Corporation in Benton Harbor, Michigan. Mm-hmm. I had never even called Whirlpool, never called anyone in Benton Harbor, Michigan. And lo and behold, I called them and the lady said, what do you want? She said, I told her what I wanted and I had nothing. I didn't have a business name, business card, nothing, no address, nothing. Mm-hmm. And she said, let me find someone for you to speak with. And she gave me the vice president of world operations. Mm-hmm. And I spoke to him and the man said, what can you do? Can you do team building? I said, I sure can. I have nothing done. Mm-hmm. All I knew is that I didn't want to buy a product and I didn't want to do it anybody else's way. I was stubborn that way. no one else's ideas, because everything was a carbon copy, carbon copy, carbon copy. And so I sit there and said, he said, how much do you charge? I don't know. I said, maybe $100, $200 for a day's work. Right. And he said, that's too low. And I said, okay. And I said, I gave another figure and it was barely $400. He said, that's too low.
Wow.
Before we finished, he gave me, I was making almost more than $4,000 just for half day's work. All right. Oh, and wow. They're going to fly me out there. And this is 20, 30 years ago. They took me out there and they put me in this hotel with two rivers coming between it in Michigan. And the person met me at the airport with a little black cap on, took my luggage, took me to the hotel room, and it was a suite with three or four rooms, and no one was in the suite but me. And he put the luggage down right there, and he said, Mr. Woods, we'll be back later on for you for dinner at the corporate headquarters. And when he closed that door, I got on my knees and offered a prayer, because I had saw all this in a dream. Mm-hmm. And I don't know if I've ever told anyone that before, but I saw it all in a dream. And it was exactly as I had imagined it in color. And wow. That's where we started from.
That's amazing. That is amazing, right? I mean, it's the, talk about the right timing, getting to the right person. And that is something else.
Giuseppe, forgive me, but you know what? The thing about it is that all dreams come true. Mm. It doesn't matter what your dream is. They all come true. You know why? Because most people dream about what they can't do.
Right.
And what do? They get what they can't do. They get the failure, the thing they didn't want to have happen. But if they spend as much time on the thing they want to see happen, they get it.
Right. Yeah. And that all goes back to focus, right? Because you're putting all your time. And I've been guilty of that. Sometimes business isn't going well and you start to stress over obviously the opportunity is there, but you start to stress over all the issues, and that's where you spend all your time and energy, and it takes away obviously from that opportunity. And I would say years and years ago was guilty of that. And someone said to me, you have all this great stuff in front of you. As a business owner, there's going to be ups and downs. So no one really broke that down for me. There's going to be ups and downs. We own the family business. I've owned my businesses for close to 20 years. And you deal with it. And there's going to be good days. There's going to be, it's how you react to those days. And that simple idea and that reminder to focus on what the opportunity, what's good is night and day. It completely changes. It completely changes your attitude. Better attitude. You see things. You act differently. People say it's all luck. And I'm like, I argue it's not luck. I just think people don't know how to articulate, or people don't know the true reason behind it. But if you have that great attitude, we were just talking about, kind of the move, that your recent move and everything else, and having such a great outlook. I don't know if you want to share that. If not, if you're not comfortable, we can. That just having that outlook alone, it, to me is absolutely amazing. I just someone in your same shoes may have had a completely different kind of viewpoint or outlook on things.
Well, that's. So sometimes it seems like you make these things up, but you if you're president of the United States, or if you're own a billion-dollar company, you still have days you don't want to get out of bed. I mean, it just doesn't matter, and you still have money you're losing. So, but everybody has to get up and have to pick themselves off. I mean, look at women. I mean, I look at my wife every day, and she came from Ukraine. She's a Kovalova part of our business, and she was a engineer. She had already been a published author and receiving royalties before I met her. And yet when she came to Mexico and to Canada as well, she hadn't seen the coffee creamers that we have. Just think about that.
Right.
Vanilla coffee creamers, Hershey's coffee creamers. She hadn't seen any of the hazelnut. She had never seen any of those things before. And being, she spoke four languages, so she's not stupid.
Wow.
Okay, and fluently. And so we think about, we have all these things available for us, all these vehicles to make it, and we don't use them. So here I am. We met on LinkedIn, and I was impressed by her leadership articles that she wrote on LinkedIn all the time. That's all I read. I wasn't trying to get a date. She was attractive and highly intelligent. But the more I read them over the years, I was impressed with how intelligent she was. And finally, when I went there, we got married, And I stayed there to work and opened up a new office in Kyiv. And we started from there. But you know what? The thing about it is that everybody has to find their gut to, I mean, you got to, I saw a license plate one day in Idaho that said, you got to want it. Mm-hmm. And you got to want it. And that's what everybody has to find. Getting your franchise, your business, what I love about you is your passion and your ethics about working with people. And, you know, you tell someone you're going to do something, you go do it. You don't water down the soup to make so you can stretch it out. You give them top service, top product, and you go out and work with them. And that's what you have to do.
I agree. And you know, it's all about treating people equally. I always say we like to empower people, right? People sometimes, oh, well, you know, the rich have access to more information or connections, or we don't. I always say I want to level the playing field and empower everyone to have the same set of information, you know, so that you can make the most informed decision. And I'm all about that. I'm all about, to your point, the why, you know, what's the motivation behind it? Because once you find the motivation, you figure out, okay, there are various vehicles to get you to where you want to be. It could be a change in job. And this is the next topic I want to talk about, career change, but you know, it could be owning real estate. It could be leaving your job and owning a franchise or running both, having a job and that side hustle, that side business. Because let's be honest, we need to diversify and protect our own interests with a lot of the companies having these layoffs. You know, you hear about it every single day, but there's various vehicles and there's no right answer. People are looking for the black and white. Tell me what to do. And that's not our job. You know, we're all adults. We all have to make our own decisions. But if I can help you with painting the picture of what exists, again, empowering you to say, okay, these are the options, but keep in mind, there's risk involved. Keep in mind that you can lose your investment, worst case scenario. You're not going to let that happen. You're going to work your butt off in the very beginning and you're going to follow the systems and hire the right people. But you have to keep in mind, just like the stock market, just like anything else, real estate, investments, Bitcoin, there's always going to be a risk. Obviously, some more riskier than others. But I think treating people and meeting them where they're at in life and just saying, you know, these are your options. These are my thoughts. It's the right fit, but you got too much personally on your plate. Let's talk in 6 months. I always like to meet people where we're at. And that's not something you learn in school. That's just, to me, it's more common sense, but I think we forget. And I think we lose that personal connection like we were talking before the show. Would you agree, or do you want to add to that? Because I think that's a big piece of what we're talking about today.
Well, I firmly believe that we all are afraid. It doesn't matter what you have in life. It doesn't matter what kind of car you drive, the big house you live in. Everybody's going to shower, strip down, and they're going to get in the shower. They're going to brush their teeth and all. And while they're doing it, they're going to be afraid about everything. How am I accepted? How many people will follow me today? Or how many people will buy my product? They all worry about the same things. We're all no different how much money we have, how much money we don't have. The only difference, it doesn't matter if you're a doctor or a lawyer. I mean, I told my wife, I said, if you took me, I said, I don't know why people live in the inner city. They don't have to live there. I don't know why they live in places in America where the water is not safe to drink. They don't have to live there. As Jim Rohn says, you're not a tree. You're not planted. You don't have roots here anyplace. You can pack up and leave. You can get on a bus any place in the world and go someplace else. And there are people that will help you start over.
Right.
It doesn't matter if you have kids at home.
Right.
It doesn't matter what the circumstance. The world is full of good people. It's not bad. There's a lot of great things happening out there. You just don't hear about it.
I agree. I think the media sometimes, it's not the exciting stuff. And I wish there was more. But I feel sometimes we're harping on the negative. But to your point, absolutely, you can absolutely do it. It's not easy. It's going to be scary, 100%. But the opportunity is absolutely there, and there are a lot of great people. And I've come across some great people that helped me along the way. And I couldn't agree more. That's well said.
It's a beautiful world. You know, Guy Kawasaki used to be the chief evangelist. That was his title at Apple.
Yep.
Years ago, and he had a website. where you could go to it and listen to all kind of curated news information that was really nice. And then he had a section called Good News. You know how many times I went to the section and said good news? It was nothing but optimism everywhere. But I didn't go to it because I wanted something that would, I don't know, get me excited, get me upset, probably right. The table or something. But I never read it, never really right. Went to it, but once or twice for a moment.
That's interesting. Yeah, no, that's that is interesting. We used to have a hotline we used to call. It was kind of like the daily motivation of the day. It was every single day. It was a college professor. I forget the school, but we used to dial in every day. It was great. It was always under 5 minutes. Kind of got you up and running. But sometimes you got into that rut, and it's like, all right, we're going to be on the phones all day talking to people. You need to get out of that rut, especially with my long commute. Some days I'm like, I don't want to be on the phone today. So we hope you're enjoying the show. This episode of Franchise Freedom is brought to you by the SMBPodcastNetwork.com. The network is a collection of podcasts and shows from around the internet, which focus on bringing you interviews with amazing guests who share actionable advice, ideas, and information for small and medium-sized business owners and entrepreneurs. Visit www.smbpodcastnetwork.com to find more great shows and easily subscribe to be notified of new episodes. It's a great way to discover quality content. If you discovered us today via the network, then I hope you're enjoying the show and will consider subscribing directly so you never miss any of our great episodes. Now back to the show. All right, we are back with Jim Woods. And Jim, this has been an awesome conversation. Wanted to talk, you know, a lot of the listeners right now, we talk about, you know, they're kind of in transition, right? The idea of career pivoting, career change, career transition has been coming up quite a bit. You see the hashtag all the time, the great resignation, and people really looking. It's almost like the big reset. People are at the point where they've worked for big companies. Through COVID, they realized working from home and being close to family that they don't want to go back to the office. So they're looking. It's kind of giving the opportunity to explore whether it's a change in career, owning a business, and things like that. Talk to us a little bit about your thoughts or advice, I should say, on people that are in that kind of that mental mode of I'm not sure what to do at this point. Should I be looking elsewhere? So talk to us a little bit about that. I want to spend some time there since a lot of people listening in are in that space.
Well, I know what it's like. I've had four kids at home, and my wife and myself, and having to move when you lose a job, and the frustration, the embarrassment, even filing bankruptcy. I know what that feels like, losing everything. But you have to move on. Mm. It's like a bad relationship. I mean, a relationship that you might have loved that didn't work out. You can't cry forever. You have to get up and set the example for your family and move forward. Because that's, you know, when I read books about history, Abraham Lincoln and the people that came here prior to before our founding in America, they came because they wanted a new place. They knew there was nothing there but mountains or trees. Mm-hmm. And yet they wanted to build new cities and make it on their own. And the books often tell me, use this word independence. They wanted the independence. And people forget that no matter what job they have, if the job is paying $300,000 a year, they still are working for someone else and hoping that the business will be there long enough. Long enough for what? You want to work for a company till you're 70 years old and retire the worst years of your life now, finally, hoping that all the promises the company made for you will still be there when they're really not guaranteed at all.
Right.
Even though they're written. So you basically, as the consultant Tom Peters says, you're brand and you are a business. And you have to think of yourself like a business. Mm-hmm. You have to go to school. You have to start thinking about your job as a business. If you own that position and say, what kind of value am I giving every day to my employer? Am I doing something that it makes me a commodity that anybody can do? If it is, then you're not being paid very much. And if you are, you're very replaceable.
Right.
Most people don't realize how replaceable they are. So if you're that replaceable, then what are you doing to protect yourself? And you're not protecting yourself, then why not? You know the hammer is going to drop. There are always going to be layoffs. There have always been layoffs. And layoffs never come at a good time. It doesn't matter if you're pregnant. It doesn't matter if you're, it doesn't matter what happened in your life. Right. They're always going to happen. There's going to be wars. There are going to be calamities and economies. What economy always stays good all the time? Never. It doesn't matter what political party is in office in the United States or any part of the world. You're going to have a good economy and you're going to have a bad economy. That's just the way it works because there's things you cannot control.
Right. And you can't control, I mean, even the big companies, when you're, especially public companies, I always tell people, you know, your manager may be saying, or your boss's boss will go three tiers up, may tell you what's going on with the business, but it's not in their control, right? Things need to get voted on. There's a lot of, lot of people making these decisions. So I would tell people your future, you're not in control. You're in control of the output and obviously what you do. And obviously you want to grow your skill set, but you're not in control there. But at the same time, I say this all the time. We blindly invest in a 401k that, you know, the employer will give us maybe 5-6 mutual fund options that we're not in control of either. We're not in control of Wall Street. We're not we're in control of the percentages we put maybe in each bucket. But I go realistically to have, and we talked about this before the show, a side hustle, you know, as a backup, a business that could cover, maybe it's just a business, small business that covers your day-to-day expenses, your monthly expenses, your mortgage, your, you know, health insurance and things like that in the event of a layoff, because it's inevitable. It can happen. Yeah, to your point, it's never a good time. You know, you hear layoffs now around the holidays, you know, layoffs, they don't care of your personal situation. Cuts are large, they're wide, right? They're hitting every department. So I always tell people diversify and not diversify your, you know, mid cap value and large cap and growth and having money in a money market. I'm talking about revenue streams, where the money is coming from. And that's a side business, whether it's a franchise or not, whatever that business is. I think that's a safety net in the event. I always say, you know, a business, there's risk in a business, but there's also, if you were to agree, there's also a ton of risk in having a job and working for somebody else.
There is indeed, Giuseppe, a ton of risk in that. And I know how people feel about it. Mm-hmm. You want something that you can depend on every day. You're willing to go to work and work for 20 years for a good company. But you know what? There's a quote by Kevin Spacey in the movie House of Cards, where this young lady that he's groomed for nothing good is very nefarious. But she says, I'm afraid I'm going to lose my job as a newspaper reporter. He says, you never want to have a job you're afraid of losing. Mm. Just think about that. And I remember somebody once telling me about a Stanford University graduate. And they said a Stanford University graduate doesn't go around looking for a job. Mm-hmm. They're trying to create a job.
Right.
If you think about it, right. They are. They're trying to create a company, the people that work for them.
Right.
And that's what people, I want people to start thinking for themselves that they are a brand, just like the company they work for, Nabisco, Coca-Cola, whatever it is. They're a brand from the way they dress, from the way they care of themselves, the way they speak, the people that they bring into their lives, their best friends, the books they read. This phone that I have right here is more than just for music or watching movies. This phone right here connects you to every library in the world.
Right.
Every museum. You got all the art here, everything. You have as much power as anybody in the whole world from this phone.
Right.
You can do everything here. So not having the tools for free, you can get it for free. You can get a free education right here.
Pretty much,
off of YouTube. Everything. We don't have any explanation. Nothing. We can do it all right here for free and get your education.
It isn't. Yeah, I agree. It's not about what college. It's like, what have you learned? What's your skill set? I mean, that's what, remember having my other businesses. It's like, yes, I understand you went to college. I went to college. I went to grad school. But what is your skill set? What are you good at? You know, it's working being comfortable working with people. That's not something that's learned in school. That's real life. You know, have you had experience? And I know for myself, sales took a little while. I was good with people, but I got nervous. But it took thousands of hours. When you talk about the cold calling, the going on sales appointments, you know, I learned a ton from my mistakes, and that's the stuff that really sticks. With your company, you know, how do you, so you, we were talking before the show, so you have obviously you have books and training. So how you know, what are your, so talk to us a little bit more about, because I want to spend some time here as far as the business offerings, you know, what you're able to help others with, whether it's individuals and businesses, you know, who is a good fit for you to work with, and how do they, you know, get in touch with you? Should they want to work together?
Well, we do coaching as well, mm-hmm. business coaching and life coaching, but these days everybody calls themselves a life coach, and particularly people who couldn't get employed at other companies call themselves a life coach. And I'm sorry to say that, but that is a reality, mm-hmm. you know? And so most, what we actually do is give companies concrete ways. We don't create policies. So you'll say to yourself, well, there's a lot of diversity and inclusion and equity consultants out there. Well, there's a lot of franchise consultants out there. There's a lot of people doing all kinds of things. A lot of teachers, a lot of people driving trucks and so on. So how do you stand apart from everyone else? Well, I really don't care about creating all the policies, because people still have the way they want to behave every day. They can behave with biases, with prejudice. And many times, the biases and prejudices we have against people or something doesn't mean that we're racist. We all have them. And we don't mean to do something that's bad. None of us are waking up every morning saying, how could I ruin somebody's day?
Right.
I mean, you'll right. never meet anybody like that. I mean, seriously. Some people do it without thinking about it, so they're unconscious of it, right. But they're good people. And so my belief is that what we do is change behavior. So I'm not trying to go in your company and change everything and say, everybody, you better start treating everybody like this. You know what? People right. go back to start doing what they want to do. It's like trying to potty train your dog, mm-hmm. all right? they're just waiting for you to leave, and they're still right. going to be the same person, same thing. But the dog has good intentions, the best that they're able to do. And so I've tried to meet people that way. I used to work for Franklin Covey Company in Provo, Utah for years. And I discovered that they and so many other companies talk about these issues and they have them written down. But you know what? People still want to go their own direction because of behavior. They train themselves for a long time.
Right.
And so what we do, we want people to recognize is that it doesn't matter what your behavior is, you can change. You're not stupid. You're not broken. Mm-hmm. And if you could be a woman who's short, I don't mean any disrespect, but you don't have to be the beautiful people they put on all the movies and so on. Mm-hmm. You can just be a woman or man who's short, who, as Zig Ziglar says, is as tall as they are wide. All right. You can be that person, and you may have gone under the underrepresented route. You have bad credit, because you didn't have enough getting started out. You may have been abused and had to go to a state college or no college at all. It does not matter. But what you can do in any part of the world, you can pick yourself up, dust yourself off, and say, you know what? They can beat me. They can spank me. They can do anything they want to me. As Dr. Phil says, they can beat me, but they can't eat me. Okay? Mm-hmm. They can do all those things, but you can get up every time and say, I'm going to make it. That's what you do. And that's what I've done. And I teach people in our programs to do the same thing. We are in more than 39 countries.
Wow.
I don't know if you know that.
No, I did not. That's pretty amazing.
Guess how many employees we have? 2. Now, how do we do that?
So you and your wife plus 2 employees, that's it?
We set it up years ago to be the only 2 employees. So how do we do all the training and everything that we get done? Because we hire freelancers. Mm. The freelancers, we don't have to pay taxes on them. And guess where we get them from? Freelancers are people that work for the big 3, big 4 consulting companies. Mm. They work on a contract when we need them to work.
Right.
We want to create a course, a program, a course. We get freelancers to design the course.
Right.
And these people are happy because they are business owners themselves now. They're working when they want to work.
And they're being fed the work, right? They're working. You're doing all the work to obtain it, right? So they're getting fed. They don't have to worry about marketing strategy or anything like that, right? I mean, they can work solely with your company.
Well, I get a freelancer marketing consultant,
right.
Right? And have them work X number of hours a week or X number of hours a month, or pay them on a contract for this coming in. But you got to think differently as if you're a business owner, because you don't want to be so top heavy, high, like Mark Zuckerberg hired all these people from Meta a couple of years ago and during COVID, and all those people he hired, he has to lay off now.
Right.
Because he didn't plan things well enough. Despite being a billionaire, he didn't plan things well enough. So what we did is we created our business to be an online business more than 20 years ago. And I didn't want any employees. I didn't want to be top heavy. I wanted to have everybody, when someone calls, I can get the person to work for you that works for us. And there it goes.
And people probably thought you were crazy 20 years ago saying no employees, online base. What are you thinking? And, you know, you made it happen. So that's awesome. You know, envisioning, putting, and that's part of the planning phase. What do you want the ideal business to look like? And there's nothing wrong with that. You know, there's nothing wrong with having 1,000 employees or having zero or two employees. I tell people feel like they have to have all these employees to have a successful business. They have to build. I just had a gentleman, Rocky Lalvani from Profit First. And we had conversations about, I have friends of mine, or friends of friends, I should say, you know, bringing in or revenue wise, tens of millions of dollars. And you find that, but it's like, okay, but what's the bottom line? And you find that, well, you factor everything in and late payments, and we're not making too much over here. So to envision that, I envision to work from home. And people said you were, and this is way before COVID, to work from home. And they said, you're crazy. You know, what do you mean working from home? You need to be in the office. You need to be engaged with your staff. My previous employee business was mostly subcontracted with some employees. My current business, I'm on my own. And it just, you know, it's, was it easy? No, I had to structure it in a way, and then I have access to, you know, I use a company that edits my podcasts overseas. That's something we outsource. We have essentially a contractor doing that for us. So you got options, basically, right? I mean, there's no shortage of options. It's really taking advantage of what's out there, creating that lifestyle, right? I mean, what you wanted to create. But 20 years ago, with the internet still being newer and everything, I'm glad to hear that it's going so well.
Well, it is for a lot of people. I mean, there are people who have lost everything every day.
Yeah.
But you know what, Dad Nabbit? I mean, when I read history books, I love history. I love American history. And when I read and hear about people having their, I mean, what is Teddy Roosevelt had? His mother and his wife died the same day.
Wow.
The same day. I don't know about you, but I don't know. I'd be crazy. And what did he do? He was a phenomenal president. He changed a lot of people, and he did it for the good. And there's a lot of people out there who have some tough times right now, help and so on. But I'm telling you right now, if you're not in a coffin, you can change your life.
I love that. I couldn't agree more. Not easy, but it can absolutely be done.
It's not supposed to be easy.
Don't give up on yourself, I always say. And I will say from a personal standpoint, it's the focus. You focus on what I don't have versus what I have, and expressing gratitude. It doesn't have to be anything complicated. I hear people and they have a 2-hour morning routine. I'm just talking about focus, whether you have that morning routine or not. But, you know, really appreciating what you have and not comparing yourself. You know, social media has really gotten out of hand where, well, he has a boat, so I got to get a boat. He or she has a bigger car. I have to get a bigger house. It's not about compare. It's about being happy with your current situation and the alignment. You know, you want to be aligned. You can't be working, spend more time with family, yet my job is I'm working 200 hours a week. That's not, you know, the alignment's not there. If the goal is to spend more time with family, that's the priority. Then you figure out how that business needs to be restructured, and maybe hiring someone else to run some of the things that are taking you away and making you a kind of, you know, be a, I don't know, chain to the business all those hours. So you got options, you know, find someone that can help, someone like Jim. I think that's huge, because I think some people just get stuck, and a person to really help them, but to also show them account, you know, bring in the accountability aspect, which I, we, again, another previous show today, we talked about accountability, saying, okay, these are your options. You know, you have, there's plenty of options, you know, et cetera, but this is how I'm going to, make you accountable, making sure that you go and follow through with this stuff. So, this was awesome. So yeah, go ahead. I'm sorry.
I apologize, Giuseppe. I mean, you have a great program and you're doing a great service out there. And I hope people who are hesitant, who are afraid, is good they are afraid. I hope they latch onto you and call you and work with you, because there's always options available. You couldn't hear the knock a few minutes ago, but that was our personal shopper. We do not shop. We have our food delivered to us. We have a personal shopper for our food. We buy our clothes online. We do all those things because we like the freedom, period. Right. I don't know the last time I went to a store to buy anything. It all comes
there. I hate
shopping. Right now, outside, we're in Calgary, Canada, and this morning it was 10 below zero. I'm not exaggerating. Oh, wow. 10 below zero. Okay, so all I'm saying is that, do you know what? Who would have thought about a personal shopper delivering your groceries a few years ago? Who would have thought about all those things? But there's somebody out there that would buy it for you, like walking a dog. When I was in Mexico, I saw people walking dogs, for multiple dogs everywhere.
Yeah.
You think, who would pay for that? But a lot of people will pay for it. So whatever you want to do, there's somebody that will pay you for it.
Yes, I agree. Even I think we talked in the last episode, even picking up dog poop from the backyard. So not only walking, but just, that's it.
It's a business.
It's a profitable business. And
yes.
I'm like, wow. And we've seen more and more, even on the franchise side, both non-franchise and franchise. So there's a business. And yeah, you have options, right? You could take stuff off your plate. It's really being willing to open up the wallet and being able to spend that money, whether it's taking care of the exterior of your home, getting cleaning, personal shopper, which I got to look into that, because I truly hate going to the store. But I think that's my homework tonight. But you know, I'd rather be recording more shows than going out shopping. So it's something I enjoy doing. And you know, hey, you only live once, so, and it's nice. I get to meet great people like yourself, and I appreciate all the kind words. You know, people that want to contact you, right? Is it more on the individual level, or the company level? But how do people get a hold of you? Website, email, what are the best ways to get a hold of you and your business?
Best way to get in touch with us, go to our website, Woods Kovalova Group. That's with the K. Kovalova is a Ukrainian word. With the A on it, makes it feminine, but essentially it's just Kovalova. So Woods Kovalova Group. They can look us up there, or WKG Strategy. They can find us there. Go to LinkedIn and type in Jim Woods. We're everywhere. Okay. They can find us everywhere. And the good thing about it is that if they don't know what they want to do, if they have some questions about their employees that are lackadaisical, employees that are fearful, we can come in and show them some techniques to get people to do more in their organization, do more themselves. Because you know what? If you got employees that don't trust you, don't like you in the company, you think they're going to show up with their best selves every day? Right. They won't. So use them the right way. And I'm encouraging your employee, the people you speak to, your listeners, I hope they will reach out to you right now, Giuseppe. There's no reason for them to wait. I'm serious. There's no reason for them to wait tomorrow and say, I don't have $5,400 or whatever it is. They don't even know what they need. Just come to you and talk to you right now.
I appreciate it. Call me. Let's call both of us. I said we should. I'm going to start doing some live shows where we allow the guests to be, audience to be proactive, right? Ask questions and just base it off their questions. I said, let's keep it simple, because I'm sure a lot of people have a lot of the similar fears, questions. How do I go about it? How do I start? Who do I always say it's not how, it's who. So it's who you know, who has been there, who can you know, help you get there much, much quicker working with someone like Jim Woods, you know, someone that's been there, done that. You can get you there a lot quicker than having to figure it out from scratch. So saves you time, brings so much additional insights. So absolutely recommend contacting Jim. We're going to put all of Jim's information, the website, LinkedIn. If there's anything else after our show, I always mention, if there's anything else you'd like to include, we can always add those to the show notes as we release the show later in the year.
Well, for every person that calls you following today, I will eat a worm. All right.
Say that again.
For every person that calls you and work with you today, I will eat a worm.
Eat a worm. All right.
Eat a worm. And if I can help your business in any way and help you guys develop, you let me know, my friend. I'll be right there.
Well, next show, we're going to see how many worms Jim's going to eat based off of the calls I get. And
bring it
absolutely.
On. Bring no, it
definitely.
On,
okay? I always say reach out to people that have been assistants. I think, you know, people that they get stuck because they don't know where to start. They put it on a Word document. It sits on the laptop and it dies there. It never gets open again, never gets implemented. So I think, you know, contacting someone like Jim, you need assistance, you know, contact him today. What do you have to lose? I'm sure it's that, you know, more of a right fit call to see if it is a good fit based off of what they're looking to accomplish. So, and you cover essentially the whole world. So, I'm in the US and Canada. So covering the whole world is a big plus. So you get the opportunity to work with Jim anywhere you are. So, thanks again for being on the show. I really, really appreciate the time. I had a blast, when I was on your show, and hope you did as well. And looking forward to catching up soon.
You take care of yourself, my friend.
Thank you.
Hug your family for me. Bye-bye.
You too.
Thanks for tuning in. Whenever you're ready, here are three ways Giuseppe can help. 1, if you've ever considered owning a business of any kind, you owe it to yourself to get a copy of Giuseppe's book, Franchise Freedom. Download your free copy at ggthefranchiseguide.com/book. 2, want to understand how successful executives make the transition from corporate to owning their own franchise? Join Giuseppe's next online presentation, Franchise Freedom: How to Escape the Corporate World and Have Financial and Time Freedom by Owning a Franchise, by going to ggthefranchiseguide.com/video. 3, want to work with Giuseppe one-on-one to identify the right franchise opportunity for you, to navigate the process, and get plugged into experienced franchising advisors? Send him an email to gg@ggthefranchiseguide.com with one-on-one in the subject, and he'll send you all the details.